I'm Earl Stewart. I welcome you to Earl Stewart on Cars.
You make more money on the lease than if I wrote a check?
Well, the dealers do make more money on leases. And the reason they make more money is because they can manipulate the payment and the down payment and the trade-in a lot more deceptively than in a purchase. And the average profit on a lease, I would say, is probably about $1,000 higher than the average profit on a purchase. There's more hidden fees in a lease. With a lease, you have an inception fee, which you probably don't even know you pay. That'll be $700, $800, $900, but you don't know you pay it because they bury it in the lease payment. There's also a mileage fee. If you go over your mileage, can be anywhere from as low as 5,000, 10, 15, 12, 15,000 is average. But if you go over the 10,000 allowance per year, they can charge you 18, 20, 25 cents a mile. There's a disposition fee when you turn the lease in. If you don't buy another car or lease another car of that make, you charge a disposition fee, which can be several hundred dollars. There's also the classic hidden fee that you would have paid if you bought the car, but they don't waive that when you lease a car. So if you're sophisticated and you're careful, you read the contract, and you do your homework, you can lease a car, to answer your question, for as little as you could buy a car. In fact, sometimes lease cars have incentives that you don't get on purchase cars because the manufacturers love you leasing a car, because if you lease a car, you're far more likely to lease another or buy another car of that make. Dealers like it for that reason too. So the whole industry, the retail, the manufacturers, all are pushing to get you to lease rather than buy. And they do make more money, but they don't have to make more money if you're careful.
Getting the actual sale price prior to getting a lease payment and insisting that that sale price be used to calculate the lease payment, that's how you avoid a lot of the getting overcharged. It still doesn't protect you against all the fees and other traps that Earl just listed.
A disposition fee. I never heard of that before. You don't want the car again. They're going to charge you for it. Or no. Can you negotiate that out?
You can. It is from the bank. Now, you can negotiate something with the dealer if you're aware of the disposition fee. These are national fees, and it depends on the lender. People don't know about the disposition fee if they keep leasing cars because it never comes up because it's waived when you release the car.
If you keep leasing the car from the same manufacturer.
Yeah, if you go back, if you decide just to turn it in and you're done with that Ford, you're done with that Honda.
Or buying the car, either way.
Exactly. Then you're going to find out about that fee. But if you know about it when you're leasing the car, you can make an arrangement. It says, I'll tell you what, I'll take this car at this payment, but I want you to take care of that disposition fee. And if you got that in writing, you might get a shot at them paying it for you.
The disposition fee, if you don't lease or buy another car of that make, is got to be paid to the leasing company. Now, probably the biggest thing I forgot to mention is wear and tear. When you turn that car in, not only do they get you with a disposition fee, but they will look at that car with a very, very severe eye and charge you a lot of money. It's a profit source for leasing companies to overcharge you for the above normal wear and tear. That you can negotiate, and you should. And probably the biggest single piece of advice I give anybody that leases a car is be present when the inspection is made of your car and take pictures of the interior and exterior and the tires and make notes. When you see the inspection report and you sign off on it, be sure it's accurate. Mileage is very important. A lease car can sit around a car dealership for 3 weeks or longer. Salesman loves cars with a full tank of gas. They hop in that car, put an extra 300 miles on the car, you're paying for it. So when you turn your car in, be sure that you're not hammered with thousands of dollars in charges for above a normal wear and tear.
I have a friend who's leasing one brand. She wants to get another one. You know, she had a Honda, now she wants to lease a Mercedes. And the dealer said to her, oh, just give us the car. We'll take care of everything. You have like a month payment left. The dealer that she wants to lease it from says, don't worry, we'll take care of everything on the old car.
They're adding the payments into the price of the Mercedes. Whatever car she's driving now, she owes one or two lease payments. They're paying the leasing company. They got to get paid. They're going to get all their money. And the dealer she's buying another car from is taking that money, paying the leasing company, and adding it to the price of the Mercedes.
But that's also a great question to do, because it depends on the dealer. They're counting on them to actually contact the leasing company, make sure it's transported back to them, make sure they're doing the odometer statement correctly. There's a lot of pitfalls, so you have to trust the dealer that's handling it for you. If it's a reputable dealership, I think you got a better shot of them doing it right, but you could easily have that car parked on that lot for months, and then soon you get a bill for payments that weren't made. And you got to make sure that, so stay on top of it. I would just be really careful there. If she does turn it into the Mercedes dealers, to contact them. Hey, is my car still there? Also contact the leasing company, I guess it's Honda American Credit, and say, I dropped it off at ABC Mercedes on this date with this many miles. Don't completely wash your hands of it, because it can come back to bite her.
Hi, this is Earl Stewart. Thank you for watching this video. If you would like to be notified of new videos that we post to our YouTube channel, simply click on the subscribe button at the lower right-hand side of the screen.